When the play opened in 7 German cities simultaneously, no one knew how the audiences would react. The drama progressed through its 8 brief scenes. So now, when this book was converted to drama, it was played in 7 German cities. And nobody, not even one single person, would guess what will be the response of the people who are sitting and watching the drama. And how was it progressed? It was progressed in 8 scenes. The drama was divided in 8 scenes, the skit. No Nazis were seen on the stage. So not even one single Nazi did that drama. But their ominous presence made itself felt every minute. Finally, at the end, Nazi jackboots were heard storming upstairs to raid the hiding place. So now, not even one Nazi was seen. But what happened? These Nazis, jackboots, what they did? They went and they raid the hiding place of Otto Frank. At the close of the epilogue, only Annie's father was on the stage, a lonely old man. So when the drama was coming to an end, who was on the stage? It was only his father, her father, Annie's father, who was an old man. Quietly, he took how he received news that his wife and daughters had died. So he kept quiet after listening to the news. Picking up Annie's slim diary, he turned back the pages to find a certain passage, and as he found it, her young, confident voice was heard saying, "In spite of everything, I still believe that people are really good at heart." So now, he took Annie Frank's slim diary, and in that diary, in one particular page and in one paragraph, he found that Annie had written something in that, and he could feel that it was Annie's voice who was telling him. What was it telling him? "In spite of everything, I still believe that people are really good at heart." So Annie had written that whatever, how let the person be cruel at nature, but when it comes to the heart, everybody is really good. So this is what she had written in one of the passage. Packed audiences received Annie Frank's tragedy in a silence heavy with remorse. So now, audiences who always seated there, they got to know about the news of Annie's death. In Dusseldorf, people did not even go out during the interval. So when it was a break time, nobody got up and went to take a small break, short break. They sat in their seats as if afraid of the lights outside. So they were so scared of the lights outside that they didn't want to get up and go. Ashamed to face each other. And people were feeling ashamed to see each other also, someone reported. The Dusseldorf producer, Kuno Eppel, explained, "Annie Frank has succeeded because it enables the audience to come to grips with history, personally and without denunciation. We watch it as an indictment in the most humble, pitiful terms of inhumanity to fellow men. No one accuses us as Germans, we accuse ourselves." So when it was an interval time, and one person told that they were feeling ashamed to look at each other, were there a Dusseldorf producer named as Kuno Eppel told that Annie Frank has succeeded, she has become a successful girl. Why? Because it enables audience to come to grips with history. It helps the audience to know what is the reality of history. Personally and without denunciation. Personally also. History, we will know about the history personally and without any condemnation. We watch it as an indictment. He's telling that we watch this drama as an accusation in the most humble, pitiful terms of inhumanity to fellow men. So this drama tells us about how inhuman people are towards each other. No one accuses us as Germans, we accuse ourselves. So it's telling that nobody accuses us, telling that we are Germans. It is we who are doing it to ourselves. So one Dutch producer says this. Dusseldorf producer known as Konoepil, explained this. For years, Germany's post-war administrators toiled to make people feel the senseless and criminal nature of the Nazi regime. On the whole, they failed. So now, Germany's administrators, post-war administrators, wanted people to feel how Nazis were treating, what was the nature of Nazis, the criminal and senseless nature. On the whole, they failed. They couldn't make people understand the cruel and criminal nature of Nazis. The Diary of Annie Frank succeeded. Leading actors received dozens of letters. So how did her diary become a success? Because leading actors received dozens of letters. So whoever had done the acting kept receiving more letters on letters. "I was a good Nazi," a typical letter read. So in one of the letters, a Nazi has written, "I was a good Nazi, but I never knew what it meant until the other night." So he's telling that he didn't know that he was a good Nazi until one night. German school children sent Otto Frank letters signed by entire classes telling him that Annie's diary had opened their eyes to the viciousness of racial persecution. So German school children also kept sending letters. And not one or two students were doing. The entire school kept sending letters. And they have told that Annie Frank's diary has opened the eyes of people. And what has it told? They've told us very clear. The Annie Frank's diary is told them so clearly that the cruelty these Nazis have showed to them. And moreover, the racial persecution. It has opened their eyes to the cruelty and racial persecution. How people are treated in a cruel way because of their color in West Berlin. And Annie Frank home was opened. So on behalf of all this, what they did was they opened a home by the name of Annie Frank, devoted to social work for young people. And why was this made? It was for social work for young people. The people of Berlin had chosen her name to symbolize the spirit of racial and social tolerance. So Annie Frank's name was taken as a symbol for spirit of racial and social tolerance. Spirit of racial and social tolerance in the sense, whatever she's faced, the cruelty she's faced because of the racism, because of the color, and social tolerance, bearing the inhuman tortures given by the people. Elsewhere in Germany, an organization was set up named after her to combat remaining vestiges of anti-Semitism. So now in Germany also, there was an organization which was opened in the name of Annie Frank. And why was it opened? To combat her remaining vestiges, to combat her traces. And which traces was that? Anti-Semitism, traces of hatred, cruel treatment of Jewish people. So it was open only to combat all this. In Vienna, money was collected for Annie Frank Forest to be planted in Israel. So in a place called Vienna, money was collected for Annie Frank Forest. There was a forest named after her to be planted in Israel. So many contributions took place after the diary was published. In March 1957, a Hamburg student suggested that flowers should be laid on the mass graves in Bergen-Belsen, where Annie Frank had found her last resting place. So in 1957, a student from Hamburg told that flowers should be put on all the graves, and especially where Annie Frank had found her resting place, that is on the Annie Frank's grave. More than 2,000 young people eagerly answered his appeal. So more than 2,000 people told that they agree with this decision. Hundreds pedaled on bikes 120 kilometers in lashing rain. So though it was raining heavily, 120 kilometers they went on bikes. Standing in front of one of the mass graves, a 17-year-old schoolgirl expressed what all felt. So, standing in front of one grave, a 17-year-old girl is telling whatever she's feeling. Annie Frank was younger than we are when her life was so horribly ended. So she's telling, we are quite grown up, but she was still too young when she passed away. And her death was too horrible because she was suffering from typhoid, right? She had to die because others had decided to destroy her race. So she had to die because everybody wanted to destroy her race. Never again among a people must such a diseased and inhuman hatred arise. So this girl, 17-year-old girl, is telling, never among us this kind of hatred should arise. And we shouldn't also be inhuman towards anybody. Annie's brief life is indeed only a beginning. She carries the message of courage and tolerance all over the world. She lives even after death. So what Annie's life is only the beginning, as it was told in the previous paragraph also. It was just the beginning. And she, what was the message she's given? She's carrying the message of being courageous and tolerance all over the world. She lives even after the death. This means that Annie's courage, Annie's book, wherein she's described about the life, is just the beginning, and it has been remarked over the entire world. And we still tell that Annie has not passed away. She's still alive, even after her death. Clear? Thank you.